Hi mommies and daddies, welcome back to MomCom India. In this video, we'll be talking in detail about cradle cap, what causes is, how can you treat it, and what is my personal experience as a mother when it comes to cradle cap. First, I'd request you to look at this picture because not everybody knows that this condition in a newborn baby is actually called cradle cap. People confuse it saying it's dandruff or it's some kind of a skin infection, but the medical term is cradle cap. Now, with that said, let's get into the details in the video. So let's get started. Okay, so first question, what exactly is cradle cap? Cradle cap is a condition that appears on the scalp of the babies in most of the cases, and it is dry skin, it is patchy skin, it could be flakes coming out, they could be yellow, they could be brown. You may feel the need to just take them off by scratching it a little, but it's mostly on the top of the head. Only in rare cases does it start to spread. It can go till the ears, it can go on the neck, it can go on the eyebrows, it can also spread down on the body, but that's very, very rare. In case you see this spreading, then the only person you should be consulting is a doctor. Generally also, if you're a little afraid to see this condition coming up on your baby, it's always a good idea to discuss it with your doctor. The second question is, when does it occur? Now, some babies are born with this condition, but some babies get this condition after a couple of weeks or a month. But generally, very young babies, say, less than 3 months, are the ones who get affected by it. It's absolutely normal. It is common. It is not harmful. It is a condition that worries parents more than the babies. Even when you consult a doctor, the doctor will ask you to do basic care at home and give this condition some time for it to subside on its own. There is actually nothing major that is needed to be done unless this condition gets worse, and how it gets worse or when is it that you have to go to a doctor is something that I will tell you towards the end of the video. The third question, what causes it? So the real cause of cradle cap has not been found till yet. There are some studies that believe that it is due to excess oil secretion, but there is no study or there is no doctor who says that it happens due to poor hygiene. A lot of parents, a lot of new moms struggle or start feeling guilty that this has happened to their baby because they are not taking proper care, because they are not taking the care of the scalp or the hair, but that's not the case. Hygiene is not the reason why cradle cap occurs. There are other reasons, and the right reason has not been found yet. The next big question, what is the treatment? The treatment is very simple. Treatment is something that we should be doing with our babies, even if your baby does not have cradle cap. This is basic hair and scalp care that we should be doing on a daily basis without a miss to ensure that not only the cradle cap subsides, but also generally the scalp is clean, the hair is strong, healthy, shining, soft, and everything that you want with your baby's hair can be done if you follow this treatment properly. The first step is oiling the baby's scalp. This is a very important step that you should be doing on a daily basis. 1 hour before giving bath to your baby, you should be applying a nice hair oil on your baby's scalp. Apply the oil very, very gently, massage deeply so that the baby also feels relaxed and the scalp also feels very relaxed. This will ensure that there's a lot of moisture in the scalp, a lot of moisture in the hair. There's a lot of nourishment. The cradle cap area becomes very soft and all the dry flakes start to come out on their own. About 30 minutes or 45 minutes later, when the oil has set in, you can take a very soft baby brush and with that brush gently comb the area where the cradle cap exists, and you will see that with that brush and with so much of oil being there, the flakes are coming out very easily. Never ever try to remove these flakes with your fingers, with your nails at all. This can cause bleeding and this can just make it a little worse for your kid also, and can be painful also. Just make sure that whenever you have to remove it, you do it either by oiling or by washing. Washing is the second step, which we will come to, but under the first step, there is still a question that has to be answered, that what oil should be used. See, typically you can use any regular oil that you are using on your baby's hair, your coconut oil, almond oil. These are very good oils for hair as it is. But I feel that when we use a combination of a certain oils, then then the result can be even more powerful, because each of the oil is giving its own benefits to the wholesome care of the scalp and the hair. So the oil that I would like to show you here is Mama Earth Nourishing Hair Oil for Babies. This is a hair oil that specializes in soothing cradle cap, because it has almond oil, lavender oil, coconut oil. Even apart from that, it has jojoba oil, avocado oil, vitamin E, all of which work towards strengthening the hair, work towards moisturizing, softening, shining, overall health and strength of the scalp. So I think that way is the combination of all the ingredients is just great. It can be used for kids from 0 to 10 years. It's a 100 ml bottle, which is for 299 rupees. Very, very easy to use. It's a pump style bottle, so you can actually pump out the quantity that you need. It will not spill over. So that way is also, I found it to be very handy. Also very important, it has no mineral oil, which means absolutely safe for babies. It is non-sticky and it has no artificial fragrance. So I really like the combination and the thought that has gone through behind creating this product. Now with the first step, where you've applied so much oil and you've gently combed all the dry flakes out, the second step is ensuring you give your baby a thorough wash. It is very important to take that oil off on the same day. In fact, after maximum an hour, oil should not be staying on your baby's head for long. I don't believe in the saying that you should put oil on your baby's scalp in the night and in the morning wash it off. That way the hair growth will be wonderful. There is no such proof that oiling in the night leads to happy, healthy and long hair. I think it's just a myth. So oil has to be removed on a daily basis. It's very important that you use lukewarm water. You don't use hot water. You don't use cold water. You use lukewarm water and you use a good, gentle cleaning baby shampoo. The shampoo that I'd like to show here is also a Mama Earth shampoo. A lot of people feel that, you know, if you use the same brand products, the combination gives excellent results. And if you read reviews about this product, there are actually very good reviews about their shampoo. So this is a gentle cleansing shampoo for babies, can be used for babies from 0 to 5 years. This is a 200 ml bottle for 199 rupees, but they have a 400 ml bottle also. This is tear-free, which is very important for kids, otherwise they will just cry their lungs out every time you try to bathe them. Also, this is made of natural cleansers like coconut and jojoba, which means that it will not leave the hair dry. You know, one of the things that parents feel is that if we wash the baby's hair on a daily basis, it will cause a lot of dryness. No, if you use the right shampoo, which actually has natural cleansers, it will actually clean off all the dirt and the dust and whatever bacteria is there in the hair. Instead of drying them, it make sure that the hair are left soft, they are shining and they are also growing like they should, because they are now healthy and clean. No artificial fragrance. In fact, a lot of parents reviews on their website also say that they've seen a change in the hair fall, they've seen a reduction in the hair fall, and they've also seen an improvement in the dandruff by using this particular shampoo. So I think as a combination, it's a great combination, and plus these are Mama Earth products, which means they are definitely toxin free. They are dermatologically tested because it's Asia's first made safe certified brand, and they are very, very thoughtful and careful about what they are making and for whom. So these are the two steps that you need to take after you've shampooed your baby's hair, you've washed them nicely, you bring the baby out, very gently pat dry the area which has cradle cap, and again with a baby brush, just comb that area out so that whatever flakes have come out, they will gently come out of the baby's scalp. So that's the second step. Either oiling or when the hair is wet, these are the two times when you can gently comb off the flakes that are in the cradle cap area and can soothe the area, and over a period of time this will subside. This is exactly what we did with Kabir. Kabir was about 2 months or 3 months, I guess, when he developed this condition. It was not very severe, very small patch on his head which had started to show dryness and a little bit of flakes. We ran to the doctor. Doctor said, you need to go back, you need to continue to do the basic care which you guys are already doing and this will go away. It took a couple of weeks, but it eventually went away. We really had to control our urge of taking it off, scratching it off or removing it with our fingers, because that's what could have caused damage than anything else. Now there are some scenarios where you will actually need some specialized products, or you will actually need a doctor's guidance, and those scenarios are if there is bleeding in that area, or the whole condition has started to spread in other areas of the body, or you see that the baby is feeling very irritated and has a constant urge to itch or scratch that area. So these are some scenarios where you should be consulting the doctor, and the doctor may, in some cases, looking at the condition, advise you for some specialized products that have to be used in that particular area. But that's something that you and your doctor should discuss. Also, I'd like to bust a myth here. I don't believe in the fact that washing your baby's hair daily can actually damage the hair quality. If you oil your baby's hair, give them the right nourishment and moisture, and then wash it off, you are actually creating a very clean platform for the hair to grow properly. And lastly, is this condition harmful? No, this condition is not harmful at all. It is in fact very common. Some people know what it means, some people don't know what it means, and hence they fear it a lot. But I hope with this video, all your fears are taken care of and you will be able to handle it more peacefully now than earlier. With that, we've come to the end of this video. The products that I showed you, the links to these are in the description box below. In fact, Mamaearth has a huge variety of products. You can visit their website and check their entire product range. Any product that you buy from their website can be purchased with a discount of 20% if you use our code, which is MOMCOM20, but that's only on their website. Apart from that, their products are available on other e-commerce sites also and in retail stores also. So depending on where you live, what's your need and where you buy from, definitely check that out. Thank you for watching MomCom India. Like and definitely subscribe.